अबाउट टू गो लाइव। आर वी लाइव? Hi, good evening. I hope you can see me. Camera has got a bit of a dust. So welcome to Exquisite. This is a collaboration between TLA and the ESET. And this is a quiz to commemorate the 75th year of independence, the festival that's going on relating to your Azadi. So we are about to begin the quiz. There are a few people still joining in, so I'm just, delaying a bit, but I'll just start with the rules. So I hope everyone who is joined into the meet has joined using their PC or laptop. I request you, in case you haven't, I'll just give you a minute to join in through your laptop and keep your mobiles in your hand. That will make things easier for me as well as for you. So your mobile will basically be like an input for your answers. I'll be showing you the questions on the screen, and the options also won't be visible on your mobile, but the A, B, C, and D will be visible on your mobile. So whatever is your answer, that you need to click on that. I'll let you know. It's a pretty decent platform to have, Kahoot. I don't know if many of you have heard about it. It's the first time I'm conducting one on this as well. So I'll start sharing my screen now. It's a VJTI only quiz, but you're free to join as well. So I'll start screen sharing. Yeah, is my screen visible?
Yes.
Yeah, so what you have to do is now take out your mobiles and type kahoot.it. I'll just type it on again on the chat. But you have to go on this using your mobiles. The first link, and there you will see a game pin that you have to enter. So you can enter this particular game pin, 2382266. I hope it's visible clearly. And once that's done, you have to enter a nickname, and in that nickname, please enter your college ID number. Yeah, so this person, you will be able to see your college ID numbers once you've joined on my screen. Sanjeet, I'll deliberately have to ask you to enter wrong answers, because I think I won't be able to get all the podium positions on this. I'll get only the top three. So I hope you'll enter the wrong answers for once.
Not playing, man. Just here to support you guys. All the best, everyone.
Okay. So there are a few people who have joined, and I think there are a few more people who are yet to join. There are about, 20? No, you're about 30 people. Yeah, I'll begin in a minute or two. Is anyone still in this process of getting onto Kahoot? Please enter on chat box or something, or unmute and just tell me. Akshay would request you to enter your nickname as your college ID number. You can exit and enter again, not a problem. Is everyone ready? Is there anyone still in the process? You can just let me know on the chat box. Otherwise, I'll begin with the quiz. It's a quiz of around 20 questions. There are 26 people who have entered the quiz, out of which one guy is just random. Okay, so we have got 26 people. Okay. So I'll begin right about. Yeah, I think I can begin. Anyone still in the process? Final boarding call. Right. I'll begin with the quiz. So first question. So you will what the next screen will show is a question, and it will have four options. You'll only be able to see the options on my screen. On your screen, you'll just see four colors, and those four colors will be corresponding to the four options that are visible on your on my screen. You'll sort of get it. I have given some extra time on the first question. So let's begin with the quiz. Exquisite. Welcome to Exquisite. All right, the first question on your screen. Right. So who designed the flag of India is your first question. You've got about 30 seconds. You will see four colors on your screen: red, yellow, blue, and green. Out of the four options, if your answer is Pingali Venkaya, it should be red. Lala Lajpat Rai should be blue, and so on and so forth. I hope you get the drill. There are about 12 or 20 answers coming in. You can be a bit quick. The quicker you be, the more points you'll get with Kahoot. I think that is something that I forgot to tell you, but okay, not a problem. So the correct answer is Pingali Venkaya. Good 25 people of you got it right. So you will be seeing a scoreboard on the very next screen. So Kahoot gives you an idea of where you stand as well. So yeah, the person who has answered the quickest will be on the top, but it's a long quiz. It's about 20 questions, so not a problem. Moving on to the next question on your screen. What does this company most famously produce? So the company's name is Mysore Paints and Varnishes Limited. Is it A, legal ink for the Constitution? Is it B, dyes for the Indian flag? Is it C, indelible ink for elections? And or is it D, paints for monuments? 5 seconds remaining. Be quick. Right. Few people couldn't answer. I understand. I gave a bit of a less time because Googling problem and stuff. Please be slightly quick with your buzzers. I hope you get the drill. Not a problem. Not too many people got this right. About nine people got this right. It's in fact the indelible ink that you put on your fingers, your index finger. Right. We are moving on to the next question. Question number three. Before that, let's have a look at the leaderboard. The top five will be shown here. So I hope people are coming up. So whom did this tiger famously belong to? There's a toy tiger shown on the screen. Which famous ruler owned this tiger? Is it Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj, Maharana Pratap, Peshwa Balaji Rao, or is it Tipu Sultan? 8 seconds remaining. Please be quick. Right, time up. It was indeed Tipu Sultan. I'm happy none of you guessed Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj. I think that's an error from my side. Okay, so these people, okay. So there are a few gainers as well. This is the scoreboard as of now. Moving on to the next question, which is the oldest regiment of the Indian Army? Is it Rajputana Rifles, Gorkha Rifles, Sikh Regiment, or is it the Maratha Regiment? All four great regiments of the Indian Army. Request you to please be quick with your answers so that you get maximum points. Right. So the correct answer is Rajputana Rifles. Only a few people could get this. Never mind. I mean, these are the questions that won't make too much of a difference. There are about 20 questions in the quiz that I already told you. And the current leaderboard standings are as follows. Right. So people are moving up, people are going down, not a big deal. Let's move on to the next question. Question number five. Is it true or false? You'll get about 10 seconds, very little time. Below brand with a French name is actually inspired by the name of a Hindu goddess. Is this true or false? Is Lakmi inspired by a Hindu goddess? 2-1-0. Right. So the correct answer is true. Actually, Lakme, the company, it was originally by Tata, and it was inspired by goddess Lakshmi. So Lakshmi gives the name Lakme. I have given all random questions relating to India, but I hope this is sort of relevant. The scoreboard standings are now as follows. Yeah, someone's on a streak. Five correct answers in a row. Very nice. Let's move on to. So that's why I've given less time for it. Let's move on to the next question. Question number six. Which country fills the blank? A note. A note is shown. On that, there's a blank space. This note is from 1948 and it was printed in Nashik. So the Reserve Bank of India was producing notes for some country. Is it Pakistan, Nepal, Myanmar, or is it Afghanistan? So we produced notes for another country. That is something pretty brilliant. The correct answer is, in fact, Pakistan. So Pakistan didn't have its own minting press by 1948. I wasn't stupid. 12 came up in 1971. So yeah, Pakistan is the correct answer. Good answer for those six people. The current scoreboard standings are as follows. Yeah. So some people moving up as well. That was a slightly tricky question. Let's move on to the next question. Question number 7. So what was the name of the boat used in the sail expedition around the globe by an all-women officers crew of the Indian Navy? So they had gone on a circumnavigation mission. Was the boat INSV Marde, INSV Bulbul, INS Tarangini, or was it INSV Tarini? This is pretty recent. I think it was around last year. Can enter your answers quickly. Time elapsing. So the correct answer is, in fact, INSV Tarini. INS Tarangini is the largest sailboat of the Indian Navy. I think a few people got confused with that. But these are the sailing vessels that have been all used. I think Marde was used in a solo expedition around the globe, but it's actually Tarini. So right, the scoreboard standings. There is no movement as far as the top five are concerned for the first time. Okay. Yeah, that was slightly tricky as well. Moving on to the 8th question. Which patriotic song is this? The text is slightly small. I'll zoom in. So XYZ was a Bengali work. So basically there was this Bengali work which had a song which translated to I bow thee mother. So the options are Sare jahan se acha Vande Mataram, Kadam Kadam Badhaye Ja, Ekla Chalore. So there was this Bengali work which had a song which roughly translated to I bow thee mother. So which song was this? I don't need XYZ. I just need the song. Very relevant to Azadi. It is, in fact, Vande Mataram. Well done. You got the Mataram hint. I hope that was pretty enough. Yeah, Ekla Chalore is also Bengali. So yeah, common misconception. It is, in fact, Vande Mataram. So there is some movement in the scoreboard. Yeah, that must be marginal. So I hope people are used to with the platform by now. We'll move on to the 9th question. Which of these is the largest fort of India? The images of the largest fort of India. Is it Mehrangarh Fort, Chittorgarh Fort, Jaisalmer Fort, or is it Golconda Fort? So there's this famous tower that you can see. That's a hint for you, all those guys who aren't able to. So it is, in fact, the Chittorgarh Fort. It's one of the largest forts of the world. So Chittorgarh Fort is in Rajasthan. There are three options from Rajasthan and one is from Andhra Pradesh or Telangana. I'm not extremely sure. I think it's Telangana. Right. So we'll move on to the scoreboard positions. Yeah, someone's on fire, man. Okay. There is some movement in the top five. So we are nearly halfway done with the quiz. This is the halfway mark of the quiz, question number 10. So these five countries' leaders began the non-aligned movement. Diplomacy-related question. Is it they are in order, by the way. Is it India, Ghana, Egypt, Indonesia, Yugoslavia? Is it India, Zimbabwe, Egypt, Indonesia, Cuba? Is it India, Zimbabwe, Egypt, Malaysia, Cuba? Or is it D, India, Nigeria, Algeria, Indonesia, and Yugoslavia? That was a bit of a hassle for me to pronounce as well. But yeah, the country leaders, if you are able to identify, they played a really important role. These five countries are from the developing world. They decided not to side with the US or Russia. It is, in fact, A, India, Ghana, Egypt, Indonesia, and Yugoslavia. So many people got that right. That's a brilliant answer to crack. This was slightly a edgy question from my side. I was not very sure whether people will be able to get this or not, but well done, guys. Kudos to you. There is some movement on the scoreboard again. So we are moving on to question number 11. We are on the second half of the quiz. Still half quiz to go. The people who are lagging behind, please don't give up. You'll surely, you can catch up because there is not too much of a difference, I believe. It is said that Hitler was so impressed with X's skills that he offered him a German citizenship and a rank in his army. Identify X. The image is obviously not representative. Is it Subhash Chandra Bose? Is it C.V. Raman, Major Dhyan Chand, or is it Roop Singh? X's skills. There was a skill that was displayed by this particular person. The image shown is of a particular event that occurred in 1936. Yeah, it is Major Dhyan Chand. Some people got confused with the meeting between Subhash Chandra Bose and Hitler. I was expecting that. That's why I gave the option. Pretty bad of me, but okay. Yeah, that's what a quizmaster has to do in a MCU kind of a quiz. By the way, don't tell your teachers about this platform, otherwise things will become really tough for us. Right, so it's Major Dhyan Chand, who was a famous hockey player. He has given India several Olympic gold medals. National Stadium, National Sports Day is named after him. The scoreboard readings are as follows. There is some movement again. So no, everyone is in the running for this quiz. I think the person on the top is doing pretty well, 5-4. Other guys, you can buck up. Not too much to give in. Just read the options carefully and just answer the questions correctly. Don't be too focused on to get it right, at the second at which the question is displayed. Read all the four options. Question number 12 coming up. Which two famous architects designed this central vista shown below? So that's of obviously New Delhi, Charles Correia Le Corbusier. Le Corbusier, Louis Kahn, Herbert Baker, or is it D, Edwin Lutyens, Herbert Baker? Famous names in the world of architecture of that era. New Delhi is the city that they came up with. Right. People need to be slightly quick with their answers. A few people getting confused with the options that I have thrown in, I guess. It was indeed Sir Edwin Lutyens and Herbert Baker. They started their own colonial city away from Shahjahanabad in New Delhi. Again, some movement there. You can see your standings. Let's move on to question number 13. So when did economic liberalization take place in India? This is a fairly direct question. Is it 1990, 91, 92, or is it 95? A date related question. I'm sure people are, cussing at me saying that, oh, who cares about the dates? But well, this is a very famous date. I'm pretty sure most of you would know this. I'm hoping most of you will get the correct answer. Manmohan Singh, of course, and P.V. Narasimha Rao. It is 1991. I don't really know why people wrote 1992. But 1991 was a period of great struggle for the Indian economy. And these two gentlemen got us out of it. Pretty well done by them. Thanks to them, we are in the current state that we're in. Some movement again. Some movement at the top for the first time. Yeah, so the top 3-4 positions are still, permanent occupants haven't been established. People can just move up, move down in this quiz. I hope people are enjoying it. Question number 14 coming on your screen. Who is the only Indian athlete to have won 2 individual medals in the Olympics for India? Individual is a key term. Is it PV Sindhu, Saina Nehwal, Sushil Kumar, or Mary Kom? PV Sindhu and Saina Nehwal, badminton players. Sushil Kumar, a wrestler, and Mary Kom, obviously a boxer. Pretty famous, established names in the Indian sports fraternity. They won national awards and stuff. It is Sushil Kumar. He won a bronze medal followed by a silver medal in the 2008 and 2012 Olympics, Beijing, followed by London. People getting confused with Mary Kom. She has a medal, a bronze medal, I think. But she doesn't have another medal yet. I sincerely hope that Indian athletes get more medals this time around. The scoreboard readings as of now are as follows. Again, first two interchanging among themselves. They must be having a kind of a mini battle there. The others are also moving up, moving down. The people, I hope you're not getting dejected because there are still a few 5-6 questions remaining. Moving on to the 15th question of the quiz. The highest civilian award is X, highest military award. Wartime is Y. Give me X, Y. Bharat Ratna Mahavir Chakra, Padma Vibhushan Mahavir Chakra, Bharat Ratna Paramvir Chakra, or is it D, Padma Vibhushan Paramvir Chakra? The first is the civilian and the second is the military gallantry award during wartime. Yeah, so it is indeed Bharat Ratna and Paramvir Chakra. I'm very happy to see the kind of response I've gotten on this question. 14 people getting it right, absolutely right. The people who don't know, well, that's the point of a quiz. There's always a next time. So yeah, that's that. And we saw President Pranab Mukherjee, ex-President Pranab Mukherjee, got it. Yeah, that was a Bharat Ratna. Yeah, so we are moving on to the question number 16. Question number 16 on your screen. Name the iconic location related to Gandhiji from where the Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav was flagged off by the Honorable PM recently. So this is the Mahotsav that we are celebrating today. Was it Kirti Mandir in Porbandar? Was it Tolstoy Farm in South Africa? Was it Birla Bhavan in New Delhi? Or was it the Sabarmati Ashram in Ahmedabad? Which of these locations is from where the Mahotsav has been flagged off? It is indeed Sabarmati Ashram in Ahmedabad. Kirti Mandir, of course, is the birthplace of Mahatma Gandhi. Tolstoy Farm is one of the first ashrams of Gandhiji. Birla Bhavan, obviously, Gandhi Smriti, where unfortunately he was assassinated. And Sabarmati Ashram is one of his most famous ashrams in Gujarat. Entire sequence of events we all remember of Satyagraha. And we are here to commemorate that only. The quiz is also a part of Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav, by the way, by the Government of India. So the scoreboard readings are as follows. Yeah, someone moving up right ahead. 1-7. Yeah, so that's a final year student. Other guys, come on, buck up. There are only a few questions remaining now. Now is the time to show all the josh you have. We're moving on to the final four, final few questions of the quiz. Question number 17 on your screen. Identify this newly constructed modern marble tunnel which connects previously inaccessible locations with ease. It is a recently completed tunnel and it's connecting something really integral to India. Think about last year we had a sort of a standoff. I've given enough hints, I think, and most of you would know this. Is it the Atal Tunnel, Shyam Prasad Mukherjee Jawahar or Maliguda? It is indeed the Atal Tunnel. Very well done. 17 people getting it right. Very well answered. It connects Leh, of course. Leh is the capital of Ladakh. And it connects that to Rohtang Pass. So that's a pretty good answer to get. I hope there'll be some movement in the scores. Yeah, some people coming up. The final stages of the quiz. Come on, guys. Got an answer streak of 6. Very well done. Moving on to the 18th question. Which of the following is the fastest train in India without any speed restrictions? Remember, is it the Gatiman Express? Is it the Vande Bharat Express? Is it the New Delhi Bhopal Shatabdi? Or is it the New Delhi Mumbai Rajdhani? So on a flat track, which of these would be the fastest without any restrictions? Is the newest train of these, if I may say so? It is indeed the Vande Bharat Express. I'm pretty happy. I was expecting people to get confused with the Gatiman Express, which connects Delhi to Agra. But it is indeed the Vande Bharat Express. 11 people have gotten it right. It connects Delhi to Varanasi, I believe. Scoreboard movement. Yeah, so there's some final questions, Josh, coming up. We've got a few people coming up from the lower positions as well. So we are on the question number 19, I think. Question number 19, penultimate question of the quiz. If I am at the Billow Airport, which city am I likely to be in? The airport is Birsa Munda Airport. Is it Raipur, Ranchi, Bhubaneswar, or is it Patna? Birsa Munda was one of the famous freedom fighters from this area. He, of course, belonged to the Munda tribe. So, it is indeed Ranchi. This is the capital of Jharkhand. I'm happy people didn't get confused with Raipur. That was the motive of putting that option in, because people get confused between the two. All these four airports lying nearly in the same region. 16 people getting it right. The scoreboard. Yeah, someone's on a streak. There is some late movement coming up. One question separating the top 2-3, I think. Anyone could win the quiz as of now. I think the person at the top is pretty happy with his position currently. We're moving on to the final question of the quiz. Question number 20. Which of these is a the national aquatic animal of India? Image is not representative. Is it the riverine dolphin? Is it the Olive Ridley turtles? Is it the gharial? Or is it the Indian mortal, the eel? One of these animals is the national aquatic animal of India. The image has nothing to do with it. I'm sorry, I couldn't post an image of the animal, obviously. It is indeed the Gangetic dolphin. It was a recent move, I think, to promote cleanliness in our rivers. I think that's something that we still have to work upon. But 14 people getting it right. People got confused with the gharial, obviously. Yeah, that's a pretty important amphibian as well. So the podium. So top three will be shown here. That third position, 15 out of 20, is 19109012. The second position, 14 out of 20. Yeah, so that's 20101009. And the winner with 15 out of 20. All three of you were nearly there. I think there was a bit of a thing with Kahoot where, you know, the timing matters. I'll show you the podium again. I'll in fact click a photo of it just to ensure that, you know, I've kept ample record of it. Although this is being live streamed, I'm pretty stupid that way, but okay. Yeah, so not to get paranoid about it, heartiest congratulations to the winners. And you'll be contacted by one of the people from the ESL or either the DLA. Hopefully, I think the ESL will be doing this portion as well. So yeah, that brings us to the end of the quiz. I hope you enjoy the quiz. You can give me some feedback as well. Yeah, I think I posted on all the groups, so you have my numbers. So you can tell me how you liked the quiz or probably didn't like it. Hopefully you really liked it. I sure enjoyed hosting the quiz. Thank you. And I hope we'll see each other again.